they are given the topic is mankind responsible for natural disasters. So I want to take the initiative. Simply, if any disaster occurs, we blame that it's either a act of God or mankind disaster. In the present scenario, it's a full, man is dominating. So we can simply say it's simply a man-made disaster.
Well, I agree with your point. What I want to say is that actually natural disaster, it mean by itself that it was occurred naturally. Okay, even those were happened naturally, man is not completely responsible, he is the one who is making it increase exponentially.
All nature, these disasters are occurring by
interconnections
between the nature, man is not the responsible for natural calamities.
In the ancient times, when the man is not at birth, but in the ancient times, many disasters has occurred. Now it is not man is the responsible for these natural disasters.
Yeah, it's got, we can see in history that this universe was also powered by a natural disaster where there is no existence of human kind at the times.
These disasters are mainly occurring by the industrial pollution. Many anthropogenic gases are released from the atmosphere by human activities. These are also mainly responsible for so many natural disasters.
Powerful earthquake was struck on Bangkok Saturday. In that many people died, thousands of people died.
Back in the times of dinosaurs, there were disasters and calamities. Clearly, they didn't state that they didn't contribute to any global warming or any nature. It is because of tectonic movements of plates. All continents are the part of tectonic, which is constantly moving. Due to that moment, disasters are taking place.
As Newton's third law, every action has equal and opposite reaction. Similarly, here mankind are affecting the nature, and similarly, nature also leading such a type of disasters like earthquakes, volcanic eruptions and droughts. As ice caps are melting day by day due to global warming because of pollution, some industrial gases.
So here I am having a point. As population is rising, as population is rapidly increasing, we humans are destroying the forest area and occupying it. So we are occupying the forest area.
So as my friend stated that human beings are occupying the area, yes, it's right. Nowadays, humans are not thinking about deforestation. They are going for deforestation for the land area for their living purposes. Because of that, so many natural disasters are occurring.
And there are many landscapes are occurring as due to the cutting down of forest, soil is losing its fertility, and due to it, it's a main cause for the landslides. And due to this, the sea level is gradually increasing, and many floods are occurring also.
As the draining of water, so many droughts are coming, so that so many farmers are committing coming to suicides. And in such a pathetic situation in India, like every year the suicides are increasing day by day.
Mankind is living in the process of climate change, and it is the climate reason behind most of the natural climate disasters in the world.
As humans throw garbage in and out of our surroundings, they are not using dustbins. and they are growing waste as biodegradable and non-biodegradable, both waste are in one only. Because of that, so many natural disasters are
in only place. Human activities is very less, and these are not affected. But in that those times also, natural calamities occur. Only mankind is not responsible for natural calamities.
Is mankind responsible for natural disasters is a topic. Actually, the name indicates natural disaster. It is all because of nature. There is no involvement of any mankind in these natural disasters.
Probably, it is happening in slow on set up is a nature which is occurred by the human interference. And some of the disasters are occurred by human beings, like deforestation,
we can call mankind is responsible for disasters, volcanic eruption, which was widespread eruption.
Well, as we know that everything in this universe is interlinked, we can say that man is only not responsible for these activities, these disasters. In history, there are many proofs showing that nature only made these disasters. As we can talk about the Great Sea in the Middle East part of the America, which was converted into a desert automatically.
We can't say everything is mankind, and how can we blame on man that for the earthquake eruptions? Volcanic eruptions and tsunami, how can we say that man is the main culprit for them?
Mainly, human activity is responsible for natural disasters. So many, like industrial wastages, releases very harmful gases, it affects ozone layer, and using heavy polluted vehicles, etc., are very harmful to nature, and it leads to natural disasters.
I see your point, but I want to say that not only completely human is responsible for this. There are some natural disasters like tsunamis and cyclones which were not created by the humans, occurred naturally.
These are also responsible for human activities, but I also support the view, human is not only responsible, because our house, we cannot destroy our house by ourselves. Environment is our house, I think.
Yes, you stated that environment is our house. I also agree with your point, and I want to say that naturally occurring disasters are not by humans, it is by nature. And so many scientists are well versed with the technology. They are well in advance. They will inform you that if the disaster is occurring. So I want to say that we have better technology, so we can.
As a survey conducted recently by the people, and they voted for both man is responsible for disaster, and someone had given an opinion they are not responsible. It is about 53% is given statement that man is responsible for natural disaster, and remaining 43% is given that man is not responsible.
Only man and nature is not responsible for these natural disasters. Both are also responsible for natural disaster. So we maintain some precautions and take some measures to decrease pollution and decrease environmental disasters by taking some necessary steps.
Yeah, what we want to conclude is that there is disasters are caused naturally, and there's hand of man in the increase. So real precautions should be taken, otherwise we will see a longer.
I
want to
add another point. In order to blame each other, whether to discuss it's man-made or a act of God, we should take certain measures in order to control the disaster. Thank you.
If I want to sum up this particular group discussion, what I found is, you are hitting around the bush. One thing. There is no proper outcome or any solution by this particular group discussion. If I come down to each and every individual, if I start from F4, that is Subramaniam. Subramaniam, you gave a conclusion part, which is very good, but still, you have a very good diction to speak, but you have a problem in your word pronunciation. Apart from this, you gave very good examples and you took many good turns. Because as I told you earlier, for 10 minutes a person should speak for 2 minutes and you have done justice for your word. Very good. Next one, you also spoke well 5F3. You also gave good examples and you have took, but you took only a few turns, so I don't know why. You can also give your value points in general better. As third person, 5F2, you are an initiator, you spoke very well, but you have a problem in your sentence framing and you have few fillers over there. When you can work with your fillers, because you have just work with that and everything is fine. For role number 5, F8, you only spoke only for a name said, I don't know why, you just came just and you have blink and miss. So try to involve yourself in your professional course. It is nothing but, you know, the way you project and the way you conclude yourself. That is our group discussion. We have come only once, I don't know why, what happened today. 5F6, very good, you have maintained a very good rapport and you gave good examples, gave very good maintained eye contact and at one point where you also brought the team into the third cutoff, because at the exam and your friends are being got deviated and you brought them, then this is the topic. It's very good. And 5F9. You have few fillers, pauses, sentence framing error, and your body posture is not appropriate. Because you know, while speaking, your one hand is with your communication system, that is pass, and other with your ID card. I don't know what your hand goes with your ID card. When you speak, maintain your proper posture and then speak. Not like this or not like this. Clear? But being a class representative, you should be a role model for everyone. People are looking at you, so please be careful. You are not a bit serious, you are very casual, you spoke only once, I don't know why. 5F7, right? You spoke only once and then you are fighting for opportunity. In group discussion, people will not give you opportunity. You have to grab it, you have to encash it. If you wait for others to give you a chance, gone. Okay? Try to be much more serious, try to involve and know. Try to put few words from your end. 5G0, you came very late, that means you are very late to this particular group discussion. Next time, see, the basic thumb rule is, when once you start a group discussion, example, if you don't have any of your particular time to speak, at least for your initiation, at least for your conclusion, but you have time for your active team player. For example, if you want to start, but anyhow, your friends have grabbed a particular opportunity and where you cannot speak it. Next time, plan at least to be in group between 3 to 4 minutes. If you have time for 10 minutes, before 3 to 4 minutes, try to jump and give your answer. If you come at 6th minute or 7th minute, it shows that you are very late in brief and you have been founding with your words. Okay. Last, but not the least, even though you spoke very well, you took few turns and see, group discussion is not between you and me, it is between your team members. Try to match, try to look at everybody. Anyhow, you have, I think you came from Telugu medium, right? English medium. Then why you're fighting with your words? Then see, the words will come only when you have a good thought process. For example, if a person speaks, already those words are in his or in his or mind. If I am finding words, that means I am not prepared for the particular topic or I am trying to hit around the bush. You spoke very well, you took a couple of turns, but doesn't mean that you have to maintain your eye contact with all the people. Like how Lakshman happened, your previous team member, because while Lakshman was speaking, I just observed him, he was speaking to each and everybody. Because